performance.
Thank you very much. Our next speaker for this occasion, the man who needs no introduction at all, because we all know him as a father. When God comes to rescue a people, he sends them to man. It was so in Bible days. Deliver his children from the land of slavery. And it is so today, for our God has not changed. And if you know the story of our next speaker, you cannot but agree with me that this is a man who has been handpicked by God and prepared to lead our country for a time such as this. This man represents experience and not experiment. Because he has gone through the mill at an international level, he served as the first co-chair of the United Nations Advocacy Group on the Sustainable Development Goals. He also served as the African Union's high-level committee that did the preparatory work to pave the way for the African Continental Free Trade Area Agreement. He's a former chairman of the Authority of Heads of State of Singapore. Currently, he's the chair of the Naana High-Level Forum on Security in Africa. In Ghana, he has gone through the mill as well. Ladies and gentlemen, he's been member of parliament for the good people of Wonderboy for 3 terms. He's been a deputy minister for communications. He's been a minister for communications. He's been vice president of the Republic of Ghana. And as vice president, he was not a mere mate, but a co-driver. He has been president of the Republic of Ghana. And by the grace of God, he shall be sworn in as president of the Republic of Ghana on 7 January 2025. He is a man of vision, a man of character, a man you can trust, a man who exudes humility and love for God and country seamlessly. Under his tenure for president, Ghana experienced true leadership and transformation. No region or sector was left out, but he was misunderstood, he was maligned, he was demonized and bastardized. But as he himself predicted, posterity has judged him well. And today he stands vindicated. And Ghanaians are yearning for his return. Ghanaians are saying they have missed him and cannot wait to see him at the Jubilee House again. Ladies and gentlemen, some call him the nation builder. But I call him Abu Brokosua, Adebeye, and Saida. Now with a standing ovation and a rousing round of applause, make welcome to the microphone. Thank you, Jamaku. Thank you very much. Let me say that. Them who were referred to by general as having chosen their positions, you may be very, very deeply disappointed. But I want to thank you very much and say good evening to you all, my brothers and sisters, my fellow comrades, and all the good people of Ghana. Let me begin by acknowledging our national chairman, Honorable Johnson Asiedu Ketia, our general secretary, Fifi Fiavi Kwete, the chairman of our council of elders, Alhaji Mahama Idrisu, and all members of the council of elders, and indeed all members of the NDC family. I wish with respect to acknowledge all distinguished members of our society who are with us today, including our traditional leaders, our traditional rulers, our religious leaders, our students, members of the diplomatic corps, market women, public servants, and indeed Ghanaians of all levels of society. You're all welcome and I acknowledge you. I also acknowledge my siblings and my family. My son Sharaf is here with me this evening. And most importantly, I recognize Mrs. Lordina Dramani Mahama. My faithful companion, who has stood by my side through all the rough and tumble of Ghanaian politics. But today we are here to celebrate one person, and that is my teammate, in whom I'm well pleased. Professor Naana. Ajimai. Ladies and gentlemen, I studied history in the university, so I always start with history. History is made up of stories. And as a history student, I've always found an insatiable love for stories. These stories are not simply mentioned from the Bible. And it's Romans 8, verse 31. And it says, if God be for us, who can be against us? Amen, and I thank you for your kind attention.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more.